interesting twist on pentatonic, so making them fitted. Feeling myself really amazed by this tune. And this tune actually has been used in Lutheran church I wrote for the Christmas. However, it's not a Christmas song. I mean, you know how sometimes the tune's moving and it's a different chords? This is actually original words. And I found the whole poem based on it. So, and we have the wonderful English. Can you read this poem? So I can read it too, but it's probably not the appropriate pronunciation. And if you stay in front and you read the poem and you also watch Anna's articulation, this is very important. Because we also had a huge work making all this transliteration. Hopefully in phonetics, you're working on this. Hopefully for the last month, we're focusing a little bit more on that point. Because again, all this rush, never enough time. But this actually goes in the picture of many pieces we are doing in our tour. It's about hope, and hope and eternal life. And this is what happened here. It's what happened is the soul after person died. It's, you know, it's a transition of the soul. And this raw river, it's the way before you make a transition to the next big.
Sure.
So when you hear the angel singing. And the idea of peace that is the soul faced with needs to go through that river and face all the sins. It's not very easy transition. But there is a pool in front. And the soul hearing the voices, and that gives strength to the soul. It's a little bit when you reach this point. It's really deep. The whole poem is just amazing when I read. We sing all these three verses from there. There's five, I guess. Right, I don't know. And when you're listening to this, then we will talk about how to transform this refrain. That's first we hear far away. Then a lot of saints. Saints in these lyrics mean the other souls which go in front of you. They start to join the singing, but those polyphonics happen. And then final refrain, and you actually reach your destination. It's really glorious and graceful. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I mean, it shouldn't be the same chord, it shouldn't be the same, you know. We need to make this like the soul. It's very close, very deep feeling of this river you need to go through with your sins. And it's actually you detaching yourself from everything that has been left on earth. Your parents, your
okay. Harp, I hear the harps eternal ringing on the farther shore. As I hear the swollen waters with their deep and solemn roar. And my soul, though stained with sorrow, fading as the light of day. Passes swiftly o'er those waters to the city far away. Souls have crossed before me saintly to that land of perfect rest, and I hear them singing faintly in the mansions of the blessed. Just beyond the river flasheth Jerusalem of my God, where the white wave rising splasheth on the shores by angels trod. Stop, I see the boatmen nearing. See, the snowy sail is set, and the oars are floating idly, and the sail is drifting wet. Call my father, call my mother, tell them that the boatman's here, and another, oh, another, unto whom my soul is dear. Call him quick, for I am passing through the valley of the waves. I am passing with the boatman o'er the deep and solemn wave. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to the great I am.
So which poem is that? Who wrote that?
It's more verses.
Which collection? Excuse me,
the traditional poem.
It's a traditional
poem. But it's from which collection? The collection of poetry?
Can I figure out the tag? I just But see the amazing things, and the music actually kind of warms your happy heart. So now you understand where is this piano from in my soulful state. That's what Paul says, right? But it's a hope. We know that the end will be glorious. It's a feeling. And more and more and more and voices and more voices and there are there. So let's just is that feeling. And this is all about soul.